the moon. 3 nights a month I look up into the sky longingly at my shiny round mate when he is at his fullest and most inviting. Humans have had their sights on our Earth's orbital for thousands of years, and more recently, there has been a lot of talk of offering flights to the moon, or even starting a research colony. But could our frail human bodies survive up there? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm your host, Rebecca Moonlover for Life Felgate, and today I'm asking, how long can you survive without a spacesuit on the moon? Before we launch right on into this video, I want to ask you guys if you would ever go to space if you got the chance. I certainly would. Leave your thoughts and answers in the comment section down below. So, the moon. Only 12 astronauts have walked on the moon's surface, all wearing a spacesuit. Of course, finding yourself on the moon's sand safety suit is a very unlikely occurrence. That being said, sketchy plans to get more humans to the moon have existed for decades. The United States government never carried out the 1950s and 60s Project Horizon, which would have established a human base on the moon. Elon Musk is desperate to get us there, while Virgin Galactic is working on a flyby. Either way, civilians on the moon won't be a thing for decades to come. Does that mean we won't answer the question? Of course not. Let's, for the purpose of this video, imagine that we are out there on the moon and oof! Our spacesuit is suddenly gone. On the last moon outing in the 1970s, pressurized spacesuits weighed 300 pounds, so that's 126 kilos, or 21.5 stone. The first thing you would feel without the suit is light. Lighter. So light. Also, gravity is 6 times less strong on the moon, so you'd feel pretty floaty indeed. You could enjoy that for all of a split second before the temperature, brightness, and vacuum got you. The moon orbits the Earth, but doesn't rotate on its axis like Earth, meaning that there is a light side and a dark side of the moon. Temperatures vary, with the top end being 120 degrees Celsius and the low end being minus 228 Celsius, neither of which are great for humans. If you were sans spacesuit on the bright side of the moon, the light would really, really, really hurt your eyes. There's no atmosphere on the moon, making it super bright, retina burning bright, so I hope you packed your sunglasses. Not only that, even without the extreme end of the high temperature, without an atmosphere to protect you from the UV rays, your skin would burn very, very quickly, and you would likely pass out or have a heart attack in response to the searing pain. If you were sans suit on the dark side of the moon, you would stand a slightly better chance. In the near vacuum of space, your body is far slower at losing heat than here on Earth. Now that is because there is no air to conduct heat away from your body. That being said, anything you touched or stood on would feel extra super cold. Without shoes, your feet would simply freeze. Say you avoid an instant burn or a quick freeze without your suit on, what would the next issue be? Pressure and oxygen. Again, without an Earth-like atmosphere, the moon doesn't have much in the way of breathable air. You would likely pass out from the lack of oxygen within about 15 seconds of standing on the moon. Then, your body would asphyxiate and you would die. If, say, you miraculously gained an oxygen tank extraneous to the spacesuit you don't have, and somehow you avoid the freeze or burn, you may live a little longer. However, the near vacuum of the moon would have some serious pressure effects on your body. The reason astronauts wear pressurized suits is because the pressure on the lunar surface is very different to Earth. It is exceedingly low pressure. Some people speculate that you would explode, but this is not quite the case. Without a suit on, the low pressure of the moon would draw out the fluid from within your body. Over a few hours, this would break some of your blood vessels and maybe even cause your lungs to explode. But in the short term, you'd feel very puffy. The eyes, nose, and mouth especially would feel exceptionally dry and uncomfortable. It is possible for the eyes to dry out completely. The only real life example we have of what life would be like without a spacesuit on is the 1965 NASA accident, in which an astronaut's pressurized suit failed in a testing chamber. Now, he still had the suit on protecting him from the air, but he did have to succumb to moon-like pressure. Jim LeBlanc was in moon conditions in a low-pressure chamber when the tube pressurizing his suit became disconnected. He luckily survived the incident thanks to the quick reaction of NASA's team, but in an interview, he said, "I could feel the saliva on my tongue starting to bubble just before I went unconscious." He passed out within 14 seconds of the accident, and the only reason he survived repressurization hospitalization was because of a very short period of time that he was exposed to the conditions in the first place. We don't know exactly how long you would survive exposed on the lunar surface without a spacesuit, but our guess is you would only have a few minutes, and you would likely pass out from the lack of oxygen and low pressure within seconds. In a worst case scenario, you could roast alive or freeze to death on top of that too, so maybe pack that weighty suit after all. So that is one question answered for you. Once again, I ask you, would you like to go to the moon? Do let me know in the comments section down below. Side note, I've decided I want to name all of my kids after moons. Baby Enceladus first. Okay, I'd better get out of here before my mum and my slew of lovers get worried. Just joking-ish. But before I go, do make sure you hit that thumbs up button if you like our videos, and you click on that notification bell if you want to be the first to hear more big answers. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video, but until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.